गुड मॉर्निंग. इन आर लास्ट सेशन वी हैव स्टार्टेड द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज़ रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ एंड वी स्टार्टेड अ लेसन विद द कॉन्ट्रासेप्शन एंड वी हैव डिस्कस द नेचुरल कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव मैथड्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ सेशन विद द आर्टिफिशियल कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव मैथड्स विच आर डिवाइडेड इन टू टू दैट इज़ टेम्प्ररी एंड परमानेंट एंड वी विल इनिशियली टेक अप द टेम्प्ररी मैथड. सो द फर्स्ट टेम्प्ररी मैथड includes barrier methods or physical method or mechanical method. Now the principle of this method is that they do not allow the gametes to meet, and when the gametes do not meet, the fertilization doesn't occur. So basically they don't let the zygote formation. This include condoms, diaphragm, cervical caps, walls. Now let us take the first device, barrier device, that is condom. Both type of condoms are available in the market, that is male and female. They are basically made up of thin rubber or latex and are used to cover penis in male and cervix or vagina in female. They are basically used by the user just before the ejaculation. Nirod is a very popular brand of condom for the males. The use of condoms is having the additional benefit that it protects us from the reproductive diseases like AIDS, syphilis or gonorrhea. These are the few sexually transmitted diseases which can be prevented by using the barrier method or the condoms. This is the additional advantage. Next is diaphragm, cervical caps and walls. They are also made up of rubber and they are inserted in cervix during coitus, and they prevent pregnancy by blocking the entry of sperm through cervix. They are reusable. Spermicidal cream, jellies, foam are also used along with the barrier methods in vagina before coitus. These kill the sperms. Now let us see the next method. You can see here the male condom and the female condoms in the diagram. You can see here the diaphragm, cervical caps. So these are basically the methods, contraceptive methods, which are involved in the mechanical method or the physical methods. Now let us see the next method, that is the intrauterine devices, IUDs. So these are the devices that are inserted by doctors or expert nurses in the uterus through vagina, and they are available in two forms: non-medicated IUDs, which include the lips loop, and the copper releasing IUDs, copper T, multi-load 375. They are the examples for copper releasing IUDs. They release the copper ions, which decrease the sperm motility, that is their movement and fertilizing capacity of the sperm. The next category of intrauterine device is the hormone releasing IUDs, Progestert, LNG20. These are the devices that release the hormone that make the uterus unsuitable for implantation. These are the good contraceptive methods which are used by females and is helping in delaying the pregnancy or space the children. Now this is a common disadvantage with the IUDs, that they cause hemorrhages leading to infections of the uterus. Now they do not provide any protection from the reproductive diseases or the sexually transmitted diseases. Now the next method that we are going to see is the chemical method. Now the chemical method is also called hormonal methods. Spermicidal tablets, jellies, creams, paste, they are introduced in the vagina and they kill the sperms. The common spermicidal chemicals are lactic acid, citric acid, zinc sulfide, KMnO4, and they are basically killing them. That is the killing the male gamete when they enter the female. Now oral devices or physiological devices is the other chemical method. It include the birth control pills, that are taken by females through mouth. They are basically the small doses of progesterone or progesterone estrogen combination, and they are used every 21 days, and they are good methods of spacing the children. These pills inhibit the ovulation as well as implantation. So with every method you are learning the principle. For spermicidal creams and jellies, you have learned that they kill the sperms. For oral devices like tablets or pills, you are learning that they inhibit the ovulation and implantation. Pills are very effective. They have very less side effects. Saheli is a very common pill that is used by women, and it's a once in a week pill. So there are many such oral pills that are available in the market that are used by females as a contraceptive device. Now the next method is implant. They are also having the progesterone or progesterone estrogen combination, and the implants are, you can see here the implant. The implant are basically having the similar mode of working as that of pills. They are used as IUDs, and within 72 hours of coitus they are found very effective. So these are basically the methods, the artificial methods, which are temporary methods and are used by couple in order to prevent the pregnancy. The next method include the surgical methods. Now in the surgical method, the surgeries are conducted. They are permanent method. That is the advantage with them. But the major disadvantage with these methods is they are irreversible. That is, once the surgery is conducted, it cannot be reverted back. Now they can be categorized as male sterilization and female sterilization techniques. Male sterilization include vasectomy, where the vasa difference is cut and tied. Female sterilization includes removal of ovaries, cutting of fallopian tubes, and cutting or blocking of oviduct. So these are basically the different surgeries that are being conducted by the specialized doctors and nurses as a contraceptive methods. One can use this method either to delay the pregnancy or space children. There are possible effects of contraceptive methods like nausea, abdominal pain, excessive bleeding, breast cancer, uterine cancer. So with this, or this part, that is the different type of contraceptive methods, that is temporary and permanent, are completed. Now in our next session, we will take up with the next heading, that is the MTP. That's all for the day. Thank you.